Hello, everyone. Nice to see you all here. I'm trying to see who all is here, if I know anyone. I see some familiar faces. Hi. So nice to see all of you. I'm Krystal Kiran. This is Matt Yang, and we have put together a couple of sets for you today. I need to give you a little bit of a disclaimer off the top. I do not have COVID, but I am getting over a bit of a sore throat. So if you hear a little bit of coughing, it's a part of the act, I swear. You get to witness what a performer does, you know, when they're getting over a cold and they're performing. The show must go on, as always. I just want to thank the Vancouver Outsider Arts Festival for hosting us and inviting us to be here today. For myself, this is my first show in almost 2 years, and so to have a space where we can pick whatever music we want to play, wear whatever we want, all of those things is really, really a gift and a treat. So thank you all for being here and braving the weather and all of those things. I'd like to introduce Matt Yang, our wonderful accompanist. Very talented man. And we're going to start off with a bit of a prayer. It's a Sikh prayer. And I invite you to close your eyes if you'd like. I'm going to cover my head as per custom. And this is just to set us up for today.
We are never far. We are never.
strange, enchanted boy. They say he wandered very far. special person in the audience, and I think she's here, I'm not sure, but her name is Sujanya. Suj, are you here? I don't think they're here yet. They're on their way, though. Kiran's here, though, and she knows Suj, so... Oh, there she is! Perfect timing. Come on in. It is this very special lady's 19th birthday today. And, you know, we gotta celebrate these milestone moments. Come on in. Have a seat. Made it in perfect timing. So, I'd like to invite all of you to sing happy birthday to Suj. It's spelled Sujanya. Yeah? Ready? What's the word? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sujanya. Happy birthday to you. Perfect timing. If you know the lyrics to this next song, feel free to join in. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute. That was my dancing for the set. Thank you very much. So that was our first set, a very short, sweet set. We will be back in a few more minutes. And so take a moment, drink some water, go for a walk, stay seated, whatever you feel necessary. And we'll be back in, I think, about, I don't know, how many minutes? Five? We'll come back in five. So this next set that we've compiled for you, again, the wonderful Matt Yang. I'd like to just give him another round of applause. I had the privilege of spending some of my most formative time in, well, I may be biased here, but, you know, I think one of the greatest cities in the world, in New York. And I was 19. I was Suja's age, actually, when I moved to New York, and it was a pretty incredible experience. I lived there for about a year, and it was actually Johnny Trin, a friend of mine, a theater school colleague. Him and I were actually in school together in Toronto at the time, and he's right over here. And I had decided to audition for a show called Bombay Dreams, and it was going to be the first South Asian musical on Broadway. And at the time, it was playing in the West End in London, and they were making their way over to New York. And in my, you know, 18-year-old brain at that time, I was like, if I don't get this show, I'm quitting the industry, that's it, it's over. So I put, you know, didn't really put a lot of pressure on myself at all. But I remember flying to New York for that open call audition. And I remember the first set of tickets that I bought, actually Jen LaForge, one of our other friends from theater school, was supposed to come with me. And she did end up coming with me for that audition. But the first set of tickets that I bought at that time, this was back in 2003, I bought them from like some really cheap flight website. And it turns out they were a scam. So I was supposed to get there the day before the audition, but found out that my airline tickets were fake. So there was no flight. So the next day was the day of the audition, 10 a.m. in New York City. I remember, I believe the auditions at that time were in the Alvin Ailey building. And I got that 6 a.m. flight to New York. Luckily, everything was on time, and I managed to make it in time for the audition. And there were thousands, I'm not exaggerating, thousands of dancers there. We waited in line for hours, everybody got seen. I wasn't a union member, an equity member, had to wait in line, finally got that opportunity to dance, and luckily got a call back to sing that day. So it was a very long day. And, you know, that was that really big experience of know, following your dreams and going there and, you know, despite what happens, like, you just have to go for it. It's that thing that you know inside that you have to do. And so came back to Toronto, went back to theater school, waiting to hear back. And luckily, I did find out a few months later that I booked the show. And so that ended up being my first real professional performing experience after performing here at the PNE when I was 16. So an incredible experience, a very full experience. And moving to New York, I remember, we all have those albums in our lives, right? Where it's like you hear that album or you hear that song and it brings you back to that time. It's almost like you can smell the air, you can taste the air, you remember what you were wearing, you can, you know, you can smell it, you can feel it, you can taste it, like all your senses get ignited. And I remember this album had just been released, and I was so excited by this artist because her father is actually a very acclaimed Indian musician, Ravi Shankar, if anyone knows. Except for the South Asian people, you don't get to answer this question. But this album came out around that time, and I remember being on the subway, on the train, going to rehearsal, and continually listening to this album. So this set is really my homage to my time in New York, and this song definitely reminds me of that, of those early days. Cultivated a state of mind. I'm gonna have a sip of water. I want to. But it really cultivated a state of mind in terms of, I think, grit, tenacity, resilience, all of those things. It's, you know, moving from Penticton to New York, it's a bit of a jump. So even moving to Vancouver, I moved here almost 2 years ago, and I feel like that kind of mindset, when you adopt that into the new places that you move to, it's been a lifelong gift to be able to adopt that and challenge, honestly. So one of my favorite artists, and I've been so fortunate to actually be able to share the stage with her, Alicia Keys, she wrote really the anthem, I would say, for New York to explain what that state of mind is. So performing on Broadway, you know, our stage door used to face the Letterman show. So I remember before every show, we would get to see all the guests that would come in, and it was like, we would just like literally sit out there before the show and like wait to see who was going to come in. It was so exciting. And as amazing as that experience in New York was, it was also the toughest experience. It was also where I experienced my first really big heartbreak. And I had a showmance. I was 19 years old, and I decided to date a fellow actor in the show. We call those showmances. And I feel like those two things had to happen at the same time. You know, I think, again, being in New York, as galvanizing and as exciting as it is, it can also be a very heartbreaking city. It can be a very lonely city. So I think that's the beauty of the human experience, is that we can experience different emotions at the same time, experience different experiences at the same time, and they're all true. It doesn't have to be either or. So these last couple of songs are from a Broadway performer, composer, writer, Sarah Bareilles, who wrote the multi-award winning musical Waitress musical. So most days I don't recognize me in these shoes and this apron. That place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. It's not what I ask for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's so true. And now I've got you, and you're not what I ask for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two. For the girl that I knew who'd be reckless just enough, who'll get hurt, but who learns how to toughen up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be something always brings me back to you. It never takes too long. No matter what I say or do, I still feel you here till the moment I'm gone. You hold me keep me without chains. I never wanted anything so much than to drown in your love and to not feel your rain. Set me free, leave me be. I don't want to fall another moment into your gravity. Here I am and I stand so tall, just the way that I'm supposed to be. But you're onto me and all over me. You love me 'cause I'm fragile, when I thought that I was strong. But you touch me for a little while, and all my fragile strength is gone. Set me free, leave me be. I don't want to fall another moment into your gravity. You see that you're everything I think I need here on the ground. But you're neither friend nor foe, though I can't seem to let you go. The one thing that I still know is that you're keeping me
of our performance.
Kiran, who was the one who made the introduction for all of this to happen, and it's been a real pleasure to perform, really for the first time after a couple of years. So the nerves were there, but you all made it really, really welcoming. So thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the festival.